pole sitter for his heat last night, and also rolls off pole position for tonight's qualifying heat.
These guys don't realize it. They keep saying they're in a first group. You know, first group,
don't
win, you're in the first heat race.
And it looks like caution lights are out, and they're getting set to stretch a rubber band real tight and smash a loud pedal here in heat number one. Chilton and Pearson off of turn number four. Eyes on them. Green's out, and here we go. Front eye of them off into turn number one. Chilton with the early advantage. Earl Pearson Jr. going to be second. Dylan Ames going to be third. With the one of Jason Hyatt looking to the outside of Ames from his fourth position as they work to complete lap number one. Chilton and Pearson starting to mix it up on the point. Pearson to the inside of Chilton as they race off turn two down the back straightaway. As Hyatt going to the inside of Ames for the third position. Into turn number three, Robbie Moses, first man on the outside looking in right now. He rides in fifth. As we've got two laps officially scored, eight remain. Chilton showing the way. He's in a rocket with the Longhorn of Earl Pearson Jr. in second. Then the Capital Race Car of Jason Hyatt in third. They are in the podium positions. And another Capital, Dylan Ames, riding in that fourth and final transfer spot as the front four have distanced themselves just a little bit now. Getting strung out here at Sonora Raceway as Ames has about four car lengths back to fifth place, running Robbie Moses. Meanwhile, Chilton looking nice and smooth right through the center of turns one and two down the back straightaway with Pearson about two and a half, three car lengths off his back bumper. Chilton working the middle while Pearson using his trademark basement bottom riding line. The halfway signals out. Five down, five to go in Super Late Model qualifying heat number one. Good. Chilton continuing to lead the way. Pearson second. Then it's quite a bit of distance back to third place running Jason Hyatt, who's got a comfortable margin on fourth place running Dylan Ames in the 77A machine. With six laps in the books, the field working lucky lap number seven, and Chilton and Pearson have decided to pull away from them. Going to make it a two-horse, two-car, two-driver race, if you will, and settle it amongst themselves with seven laps now in the books. Got one ahead of myself for a while ago. We now have seven down. Pearson slipped a bit off turn two. That gives Chilton a little bit of breathing room as they work off turn number four. And they'll get the two lap to go indicator, two to go in Super Late Model qualifying heat number one. Chilton continuing to lead the way. With Pearson second, Hyatt third, and Ames fourth. White flag in the air, one lap to settle the issue here in this one. Chilton working off turn two for the final time. He'll roll down the back straightaway. Set that machine down in turn number three and off turn number four, the Wild Child. Sub-Ice of Kentucky's Michael Chilton, the winner of heat race number one. Earl Pearson Jr. will come home in the second spot. Third will be the one of Jason Hyatt. And fourth goes to the 77A of Dylan Ames. So your top four transferring on. Fourth, the 77A of Dylan Ames. Third, the one of Jason Hyatt. Second, the one of Earl Pearson Jr. And picking up the victory in a Super Late Model qualifying heat race number one in the Caton Industrial Painting Parkview Home Center. Urban Enterprises, Chilton Lawn and Maintenance sponsored a Rocket chassis with a Mike Bullock race engine making a horsepower beneath the hood. Out of Salmice, Kentucky, big round of applause for the Wild Child, Michael Chilton. In the field, going to see the one to go signal will be coming to green next time around. Again, heats three and four, stage them up. Heats three and four, you need to be in staging, please. Thank you. Get set to come to green here off turn number four. Davenport and Roberts. Green is out and we're underway. Race into turn number one and off of turn two is going to see Superman nose out in front. But see Rob looks to the outside of Superman. They'll go door to door into turn number three for the race lead. Off of turn four, side by side, just like they started. Davenport and Roberts. All the way into turn number one now with Zach Leonardi in third, Austin Horton in the fourth spot. Roberts gets a little bit of an advantage now on Davenport as they race into turn number three to complete lap number two. He has Leonardi and Horton go at it for third and fourth. Aaron Ridley rides in fifth with two laps in the books. Roberts working the middle and high side while Davenport looks to be married to the bottom here in the early going of heat number two. But Horton in the 16, Leonardi in the 24. Good battle for that third position coming at you down Main Street here at Sonora Raceway. Give it up for third that time by to Leonardi. Meanwhile, Roberts starting to stretch his lead a bit over to Davenport as we start to close in on the halfway point of Super Late Model qualifying heat number two. Roberts with the lead. Davenport is second. Horton now has taken control of the third position. Shuffle Leonardi back to fourth. Roberts continues to lead the way as the halfway signal goes down on this one. Five down, five to go. Phil working lap number six. And Roberts working off turn number four, slowly pulling away from Davenport here in the waning laps of this one with less than four to go now. Roberts on the point. Davenport second, Horton is third, Leonardi fourth, Ridley fifth, then it is Scott and Reese. He has got seven lucky laps completed in this one, three to go. And it is all Casey Roberts out in front right now in that 101 machine. We'll work off turn number four. We've got two to go being shown to him here in Super Late Model qualifying heat number two. Casey Roberts rolling that long horn down the back straight away and putting some distance between himself and the very right house car driven by Jonathan Davenport as the white flag goes down. One lap to settle it here in this one. Roberts down the back straight away for the final time. And now makes his way off turn number four. Tocoa, Georgia's Casey Roberts, the winner of Super Late Model qualifying heat two. Jonathan Davenport will come home in second. Austin Horton will finish in third. Fourth will go to Zach Leonardi. Those four going on to the main event. And if we're getting the one to go signal. Fourth and final heat drivers, you should be over there in staging ready to go, please. Craig Lamb Auto Feature be making your final preparations. Canadian Ricky Wise and Ottawa, Tennessee's Riley Hickman in charge of the start. Off turn four, green's out. And here we go. Four more going to the show. They race off into turn number one. Riley Hickman's going to roll the top side off turn two and grab the early advantage. Ricky Wise will be second. Clint Smith battling with Hunter Millwood for the third position as that pair works off four. Put Cat Daddy to third. Shuffle Millwood back to the fourth spot with one lap officially in the book. And Mason Massey looks to the inside of Millwood as the two youngsters go at it for the fourth and final transfer position here. And Super Late Model qualifying heat three up front, though. It is Riley Hickman showing the way out in front here in the early going of this one and put Mason Massey now into position number four as they race down into turn number one. He's right down on the bottom. If he was running any lower, he'd be up in the edge of the infield, bicycling on the inside retaining wall. Meanwhile, the front three there of Hickman, Wise, and Smith putting a little bit of distance on them. That battle for the fourth spot, Massey is fourth, and here comes Millwood looking back to the outside. And Jason Fitzgerald getting in the mix as well. Millwood trying to work around the outside of Massey, and Millwood may, yes he will, by half car length, put Millwood back into the fourth position there as they go by the start-finish line. And Millwood clear of Massey for the time being for the fourth spot. Meanwhile, the halfway signal down on this one. Five down, five to go. Riley Hickman continues to lead the way. With Ricky Wise in the second spot, Clint Smith third, but Massey continues to battle with Tyler Millwood. Thought about the slider, then thought better of it. Millwood got to hang on to that fourth and final transfer spot for the time being. Massey fourth. Fitzgerald riding in 6A. It has been one whale of a battle back there.
There was problems on Fitzgerald's machine. He rolls up to the top side of turn number two. And we're slowed, and caution is out. Caution is out for Middleburg, Florida's Jason Fitzgerald with Wise, Smith, and Millwood in the transfer spots as they bring them back to green here off turn number four. Here we go. Off of turn two, Hickman will lead the charge down the back straight away. Clint Smith with a good run to the inside of Ricky Wise as they enter turn number three. Wise, though, keeps the car nice and straight around the bottom, and he'll keep Cat Daddy at bay for the time being with seven down, three to go here in Super Late Model Heat number three. Hickman, nice and smooth in that CDRA's car, showing her away on all steel motor, making a horsepower beneath the hood of that machine. He captured the $200 steel engine bonus last night, and with less than two to go now in this one, showing away as Clint Smith looks to the inside of Ricky Wise for the bridesmaid spot into turn number three as they come to the white flag, one lap to settle it here in qualifying heat number three. Hickman with it well in hand, put the Cat Daddy into second now. Clint Smith second, Ricky Wise is third, Tyler Millwood fourth, and that looks to be the way they'll finish. Ooh, Tennessee's Riley Hickman, the winner of Super Late Model Heat number three. Clint Smith will finish in the second position. Third will be the seven of Ricky Wise, and a fourth goes to the 31 of Tyler Millwood. So your top four finishers going on out of this one. Finishing fourth, the 31 of Tyler Millwood. Third, the seven of Ricky Wise. Second, the 44 of Clint Smith, and the winner of qualifying heat number three in a CVR race car, the American Billet Tucker Mobile Home Sales, a sponsored machine for the driver out of Ooltewah, Tennessee. Big round of applause for Riley Hickman. Getting set to come to green here in the fourth and final heat off of turn number four. Eyes on him. Green is out, and here we go. Last night's winner, Michael Page, looking to grab the race lead down into turn number one. He's going to have that done. Glenn Morris out of Fayetteville battling with Ackworth, Georgia's T.J. Reed for the second spot into turn number three. And off turn four, fourth place is Shannon Buckingham here on the opening lap of this one. Page with the lead. Reed goes to second now in the 41. Missed the show last night, but looking racy here early on in Super Late Model qualifying heat number four. Also missed the show by a couple of cars last night, but running third right now. That is Glenn Morris in the 14. He sets third. Shannon Buckingham, the 50 car, rides in fourth. Now Reed trying to get racy with Page. Last night's feature winner for the lead with three down, seven to go in this one. Page trying to protect that bottom line. Done the majority of his work in the A-Main last night up on the top shelf, but working the bottom side, the basement, if you will, here in qualifying heat number four with four laps halfway, or four laps in, one lap shy of the midpoint, then time by. Page will lead him off two. Once again, down the back straightaway, Reed has settled in to the second position now. Looks like he's satisfied with where he's at. Glenn Morris rides in the third spot. Shannon Buckingham is fourth. Jason Croft, first man on the outside right now. Looking in, he is fifth. David Payne is in sixth. And your seventh place car is Eric Hickerson. We'll have six scored this time by. And Michael Page continuing to work beautifully down around the bottom of the racing surface. And Hickerson will pull the 98 car to the infield pit area. His night looks to be finished. As we'll complete a lucky seven laps this time by here in the final qualifying heat of the night. Michael Page with it in hand at this point. T.J. Reed is second. Glenn Morris holding down the third spot, but Shannon Buckingham now starting to challenge him for that third position as that pair enters turn number three as the field gets the two lap to go indicator right here. Eight down, two to go in the final Super Late Model qualifying heat of the night. Buckingham trying to work to the inside of Morris, not able to make the move for third as of yet. Meanwhile, your leader rolling off turn number four to the white flag. One lap to go in the fourth and final Super Late Model qualifying heat of the night. He had it as page one last night. Can he make it page two here tonight? Douglasville, Georgia's Michael Page, the winner of Super Late Model Heat number four. T.J. Reed will come home in second. Third will be the 14 of Glenn Morris. And fourth will go to the 50 of Shannon Buckingham. So your top four finishers that go on to the big show out of this one. Fourth to 50 of Shannon Buckingham. Third to 14 of Glenn Morris. Second to 41 of T.J. Reed. And the winner of the fourth and final heat race of the night, last night's winner in Detroit, Baird-owned at Sweet Bloomquist Race Car with an Andy Durham race engine, sponsored by Baird Transport Elite Concrete. He is out of Douglasville, Georgia. A big round of applause for Michael Page. Wave your hands in caps and wave with your favorite driver. They're going to wave right back at you and wish them Godspeed for the next 50 laps here at Sonoco Raceway. The Schaefer's Oil Spring Nationals presented by Sunoco Race Fuels and Tennessee RV Super Center. Sonoco Raceway, here they are. And for you folks over on the backstretch and around turns one and two, they're going to stay four wide for you as well. So jump up there. Jump up and down and wave to your favorite driver as well before they break out and go two by two double file, just like Noah took the animals on the ark. And the field starts to roll out. They'll spin the tires a little bit to get some heat in them before we stack them up and go green. Caution lights are out. And we're going to smash a loud pedal next time by Donald McIntosh into seven, Brandon Overton in the 116, in charge of the start, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime! And Donald McIntosh going to lead the field off into turn number one. He's going to lead them off turn number two. As Marler and Overton go at it for the bridesmaid spot, Overton's going to have it as they dive into turn number three. As the field working off turn number four, almost three wide for the lead. McIntosh will lead them through on the lap number one. As the field now works off turn number two, McIntosh trying to keep Overton behind him as Dale McDowell works beneath the 157 of Mike Marler for the third position. Last night's winner, Michael Page, done it on the top side last night, trying to get the fifth spot wrestled away from Casey Roberts as that pair battles into turn number one. And Page trying to make it work on the high side. Man, he's going to get it done. Looks like down into turn number three. Meanwhile, McDowell and Marler going at it for the three spot. While up front, Donald McIntosh puts a little bit of breathing distance between himself and second place running Brandon Overton at this point. And then it's about that much of a gap back to the third place machine of Mike Marler, who's trying to hold off the charges of Dale McDowell. McDowell running his traditional low side line here as we're four laps into this event, 46 remain.
With 46 to go, Mike Marler trying to hold off Dale McDowell as they go into turns three and four, but Casey Roberts still feeling the pressure off the Douglasville driver of Michael Page. Two by two as they continue to go to the line. Great balance so far around one of the baddest bull rings in the South. And check out Riley Hickman starting to make his way up. Still got a little pressure off higher than Clint Smith, but great racing all around the Speedway, Michael.
And business starting to pick up for the third spot between Dale McDowell and Mike Marler. And McDowell's going to take the three spot with out here on lap number seven. So McDowell goes to third. Meanwhile, up front, McIntosh sets the pace. Working off turn number two, keeping that car nice and straight right through the center of the Speedway. McIntosh, your leader, pulling away ever so gradually from second place running Brandon Overton at this point, and McDowell's come off the bottom. He's going to try that middle and high side and see if he can make it work. Now he'll dive right back to the bottom in turn one and two. Marler shuffled back to fourth. While last night's fourth place finisher, Casey Roberts, right now rides in fifth. The winner last night, Michael Page, is sixth, and he's getting pressure from Earl Pearson Jr. right now, who rides in the seventh spot. But McIntosh out for a Saturday night drive right now. He's got clear racetrack in front of him. He talked about how the air took a little bit, took some of the air off the nose of his car last night when they were battling up there. But right now, he's got clear track in front of him as we've got 10 laps downfield, working lap number 11. And McIntosh with about a half straightaway advantage back to second place, running Overton.
Right now, he's starting to approach that tear group, the most wanted list in the back, known as the back half of the field. He's going to have to deal something with them and try to navigate through that treacherous group. But so far, the field's starting to get settled in as guys are starting to find their little spot in the track and trying to ride it out. But, man, Dylan Ames, T.J. Reed, Clint Smith, those guys are shooking and jiving. Man, the cat daddy just really took a big swipe at T.J. Reed, and that just made that field bunch up good and tight back there for the 9th, 10th, 11th position.
Yeah, and if we continue to stay green here, your race leader, Donald McIntosh, going to close up on him here in a little bit. Robbie Moses was the first car to go a lap down, took an emergency provisional. It looks like he's going to call it a night. He'll make the left turn into the infield, so Moses' night is finished. So McIntosh with clear track in front of him once again at the for the moment. The next car he'll roll up on will be the 1C of Kenny Collins, who has the 50 of Shannon Buckingham right in front of him. And we'll see if McIntosh changes his line. If they stay where they are right now, the lap traffic will play to McIntosh advantage because he's working the middle and high side of the racing surface here at Sonora Raceway. Brandon Overton holding down the runner-up slot. Dale McDowell still right around the bottom, just like he did last night. He works position number three. Mike Marler holding down the fourth position. Now Casey Roberts starting to get some pressure from the one of Earl Pearson Jr., who rides in the sixth spot. As that pair races off into turn number one now, who has the field working lap number 17. Best battle in the top five right there between the 101 of Roberts and the one of Pearson. Roberts up on the top shelf. Pearson in his traditional basement bottom riding spot, trying to gain some ground and pick up one more position, snatching that fifth spot away from Roberts, but has been unsuccessful at this point. Meanwhile, up front, race leader Donald McIntosh going to start the process of working traffic here. We have 18 laps complete.
18 laps in as the field continue to storm around the speedway. Michael Shilton is starting to work his way up through the field as he picked up the fourth heat race. Him and EPJ have been slowly gaining ground on the top five as they've slowly worked around. But now lap traffic has got Donald Mack in a fit as he's trying to work his way around them. That has allowed Brandon Overton to cut that lead down to a quarter of a straightaway, and they continue to slug it out as they head to the straightaway there, Mike.
20 laps in the books, 20 down, 30 remain. And McIntosh's advantage has shrank just a bit. Yes, they're clear of a couple of slower cars. Overton going to have to work that same pair of cars now, Fitzgerald and Collins, as the front duo races off into turn number one. McIntosh comes off the top, goes to the bottom this time in turns one and two, working down the back straightaway now. And the next car he'll have to negotiate will be the 50 of Shannon Buckingham. Meanwhile, Overton stays right in the middle and around the top. He's got a comfortable advantage over third place running Dale McDowell here at this point as we start to close in on the halfway point here of tonight's 50-lap A-Main at Sonora Raceway for the Schaefer's Oil Spring Nationals presented by Sunoco Race Fuels and Tennessee RV Super Center. McIntosh trying to work past Buckingham on the bottom side of turn one and two. Has maybe increased his advantage back out over Overton just a little bit, about a third of a straightaway now. And then about that much back to third place running Dale McDowell. Everybody's kind of settled in, as Dwayne mentioned earlier, trying to find a spot where their car will work the best here at Sonora Raceway. As we get ready to see the halfway indicator this time by off turn number four, 25 in the books, 25 to go for race leader Donald McIntosh.
Man, what a great race back there for the fourth position. Casey Roberts is starting to wake up and he's starting to get closer to Dale McDowell. But EPJ and Mike Marler, Michael Shilton, those guys are right there. Three wide on turn four, coming to the line. Mike Marlar fight back with EPJ as they go back off into turns one. And they still got a lap car sitting in front of him. As Casey Roberts gets around Kenny Collins, Mike Marlar to move back around EPJ. A great battle, Mr. Michael, as they are dealing with a great show tonight.
And Michael Chilton has caught that duo as well to make it a three-way dance for that final spot in the top five. Marlar and Pearson duking it out right there, and Pearson looking to the inside of Marlar now for that fifth position, while Chilton thinking about putting it up on the top shelf to try to drive around them. He's going to go between them and a three wide for fifth down the main straightaway. Great move by Chilton, and Chilton's rocket is fired. There's still three wide for the five spot off two down the back straightaway. Now Marlar clears that pair momentarily. Meanwhile, your race leader, Donald McIntosh, has seen his advantage shrink as the 116 of Brandon Overton has closed in on the leader as they race into turn number three. And Dale McDowell has closed in on Overton as well. And Casey Roberts looks beneath Dale McDowell, for position three off two, but not able to make it stick as we've got 20 to go. Or we'll have 19 to go this time by. Overton looks to the outside of McIntosh. All four, too close to call that time by at the line. Overton trying to step to the outside of McIntosh, and he's going to grab the lead down into turn and number three. Put Brandon Overton on the point here on lap 32.
Seems like the tires have gotten really hot on the 7 car this track. You got to keep those tires cooled off as long as you can, especially during a long run. Now Dale McDowell knocking on the outside of Donald McIntosh as they go into turns one. He is the Mac Daddy, is starting to get some work, but Casey Roberts, after a flawless run down there in Milton, Florida last week, he has made his presence known. They're about to have a show coming out of Florida Sonora Raceway, steel cage man getting underway. Contact at the, on the wall down the front stretch for Roberts. He is closed up that much more by Brandon Overton. Driving off into the Sonora Raceway moonlight there, Michael. Oh, Spanky, we got a show tonight, brother.
This one's been a dandy, sir, no doubt about it. Overton will lead the field off two down the back straightaway. McIntosh taking on to second. McDowell is third. Roberts, after that bit of contact with the outside front stretch wall, has recovered to hang on to that fourth position. There's a front four. You could almost throw Grandma's quilt over them as they race off turn number two down the back straightaway. And Overton with a little bit of advantage, a bit of breathing room right now over McIntosh. McDowell throws the slider on the slower car of Shannon Buckingham. And Roberts right there on McDowell's back bumper as we're working lap 38 of this one at this point. And Overton clear of the eight of David Payne. But McIntosh is close right back up on Overton's back bumper now as they race off four down Main Street here at Sonora Raceway. D-Mac trying to find a way around Overton. And McDowell now trying to clear David Payne, and he's got Casey Roberts right there on his back bumper as well. He has a Michael Chilton, the 97, looks to be in the fifth position right now. Good run for the Kentucky driver.
And Donald Mack making a big beeline charge after the 116. You don't want no problem with me there, big fella. We're going to slug this one out to the checker flag. 10 laps to go. They have crossed the strike. They're getting it on side by side over in turns number two. Donald Mack's got a bobble, and that's going to cost him dearly. They go into turns three, and the rest of the field still trying to sort out lap traffic. It's really starting to make these guys dip, dip, dive, and push around on this speedway.
As they work off turn number two, once again, Overton with a car length on McIntosh into turn number three. We're going to have 42 laps complete this time by, and this one may not be settled yet. McIntosh, and we got a spin up in turn one and two. T.J. Reed and Clint Smith have tangled up in turn one and two. This is definitely one racy little joint, one racer places I've been to in quite some time. Caution lights are out. We're coming back to green with less than 10 to go. Series rules, it'll be a single file restart. We'll bring them back to green. Let's see what shakes out now. Is race leader Brandon Overton going to have clear traffic in front of him as he sets sail off turn two down the back straightaway here to try to finish this one out and pick up a $6,000 payday. Young man very successful at the end of the 2016 season after climbing in the Randy Aver Racing on the Longhorn Cornette-powered machine and putting some distance between himself and second place running Donald McIntosh. Dale McDowell holds down the third spot. Casey Roberts is fourth. Mike Muller back around the 97 of Michael Chilton for the fifth spot. So Chilton rides in sixth. Pearson is seventh. Page is eighth. Hyatt ninth. And Davenport is tenth. As we've got a quick six dash to finish this one. 44 in the book. Six to go. And Overton trying to keep McIntosh behind him. D-Mac closes it back up on him just a little bit as the front two have put some distance a bit between himself and third place running Dale McDowell. As we've got five laps to settle the issue here at Sonora Raceway. And Overton and McIntosh going to try to settle the issue amongst themselves. You got to wonder if D-Mac's going to lay his cards on the table. If he's got anything for Weaver, or excuse me, for Overton in the Weaver ride, he's going to have to do it here pretty quick. As they race down the back straightaway once again, Overton the leader, McIntosh second, McDowell third, Roberts fourth, and Marler fifth. The time five has stayed unchanged as we've got less than three laps to settle it as they work down the back straightaway here and into turn number three. McIntosh closes up on the 116 machine.
Two laps left in this one as the Bullhorns are up. They're getting close. Donald Mack is chasing them more faster than the money from an athlete's girlfriend. White flag is out on this field and take them home with it, Spanky.
And McIntosh fires a slider, but Overton comes right back. They go side by side for the lead down the back straightaway. Contact. Who's it going to be? Through turns three and off of turn four. Give the win to Donald McIntosh. Brandon Overton will come home second. And Dale McDowell third. Wow, what a final lap.
How about that victory?
Talking about breaking the bank.
Very jubilant winner down here on main straightaway. Donald McIntosh, congratulations. Talked to you in the pit area earlier today. And, you know, we said last night the way that deal shook out, any one of you top three could have won it tonight. We're calling a race there, and with about three to go, I said, if D-Mac's got anything for him, he's going to have to put the cards on the table. And you roll the dice entering turn number one with the slider there after you took the white flag. Tell us about that last lap down the back straightaway.
First off, to God be the glory. Second, I didn't expect TJ to slow down. He had a pretty good pace, and I knew I could clear the 116. And the 41 was rolling, and then he slowed down in the middle. I'm like, oh, buddy, I'm committed now. But, oh, man, what an awesome night. We had a great car. I messed up there in the middle a little bit. Started letting the car push in some. But, man, I can't thank these guys enough. What a night. So this is just awesome.
I believe you're just a little bit excited, young man. There's no doubt about that. Talk about the folks that helped make your efforts possible.
Stowers Cat, Blunt Excavating, Tennessee RV. Vic Hill Race Engines, Rocket Chassis, everybody that's a part of this deal. It's, man, what a fun night. It's this track doesn't disappoint. Even in the rubber, it's still going to be fun. So, man, it's can't thank the track guys enough. What a great night.
Give him a big round of applause. Donald McIntosh picking up the win here at Sonora Raceway. Got a few words with our second place finisher, Brandon Overton, out of Evans, Georgia. Young man, you come home second here tonight in Randy Weaver's race car. Now you got to be disappointed. Said to Donald right there when we were calling a race with about three to go, I was saying if D-Mac's got anything for you, he's going to have to put his cards on the table right here. And he threw them all out there with a charge down into turn one with the slide job. And then you all had to fight with a slower car down the back straightaway. Talk about the finish.
That's right. Yeah, he did what he had to do, I thought he was going to go in there and wipe that lap car out, but I checked up a little bit. I probably should have just stayed in. I probably would have cleared him back down the straightaway. But what you do, it's how it goes. Won them like that before, and, keep losing them or whatever. When you're out front, you're kind of sitting duck. I just thought it rubbered up enough where I could just roll in there and just ease off. But anyway, we had a pretty good car, just go on to next week and go over to the Lucas races and see what we got for them guys.
And you jumped in this car at the end of the 2016 season, and a lot of high expectations. I know you've had some good runs here early. You got to be excited about your 2017 prospects.
Yeah, we're going to be good. Like I said, we're getting better every week. You know, we're all learning each other still. But can't thank Randy Weaver and Chip Stone and all the guys that help us enough for this thing. My guys, you know, Josh Burrow and Vinny, and you know, I hate it for them. Like I said, I don't know. I just go back and watch and see what I could have done a little different and learn from it and go on. And thank all these guys that help us, Cornette Race Engines, Willie's Carburetors, JRI Shocks, Mission Transport, Stone, Clearing and Excavating. Just can't even think right now, but just Ted Brown, Paint and Body, just everybody that helps. You know, we couldn't do it without them.
A round of applause for your runner-up finisher here at Sonora Raceway, Brendan Overton. We get in here with our third place finisher, Mac Daddy Dale McDowell, another podium finish, one spot back tonight from last night. We talked, you want to be one spot further up, but you come home third place tonight, and another great night for you and your brother's race team.
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank all the guys that work on the car, Shane and David and Jimmy and Little Man Todd and Textron Off-Road and all the Kinzer companies, Brandon, Will Kinzer Foundation and Klotz and Comedic and just everybody involved, Boyd Speedway, everybody involved with this thing to let us come do this, first of all. And second of all, the race got interesting here. I was probably about a third place car was riding there. I could gain on them at one point in time, but just really... you know, it kind of got single lane there in the middle of the race, so I thought, well, you know, when we get to lap traffic, it'll get interesting, and it did. but I wasn't able there, you know, be there to take advantage of it. So we need to do this a little bit. Was a little bit off tonight, but I was hoping it'd just stay slick, but it didn't do that. So we'll come back next time. This is an awesome place, though.
A round of applause for your third place finisher out of Chickamauga, Georgia, Dale McDowell.